rumors that, oh, they call him Tookie because he took things. He took leather jackets. That's not true. That was a given name. Welcome back to Intimate Talk with Mama Boo. I have a special one here with me today, you guys. I have Bonnie Taylor Williams. And how are you today?
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm good. I am so thankful that you came and sat down with me.
I'm glad to be here.
Thank you, because I have so many guys and I'll be wanting to interview women.
Yeah.
Just so we can get the woman's perspective of different situations.
Right.
And I'm just so happy and grateful that you are
here. I'm glad to be here.
Thank you. So let's get it started. So give me a little bit of your background. Where were you born and raised?
I was born and raised in Los Angeles. Born and raised here in Los Angeles, California. Been here all my life.
Okay.
Yeah.
What schools?
I came up in the Imperial Courts Projects, where I went to Grape Street Elementary, and then Woodcrest Elementary, okay, and then Washington, a little bit of Fremont.
Oh,
Henry Clay, I forgot. Yeah, I went to Henry Clay Junior High right around here.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. So how was your childhood growing up? How would you describe that?
Fun. We had, girl, the projects was popping. It was fun. It was fun.
Okay.
We had fun growing up, even until junior high. You know, everything,
okay.
We had fun.
Okay, that's what's up, because it's a difference now with the kids and the parents stuff. Because I know more of your era is it took a village to raise a child, and it's like the whole block, the family, everything now is like, don't say that to my kids.
Right.
So it's
right.
A big difference
right.
From your era versus the era of now.
And it shows in everything that's going on.
Absolutely.
You know, everything that's going on around us kind of stems from that. From taking that village.
Right.
You know, and that goes back to society.
Yeah.
You know, when they took, we got spanked in school. We got swapped. No.
I missed that.
Yeah, we literally, at Henry Clay Junior High School, girl, it
I
was
heard.
Nothing for that principal to call me in there, and I had to boot over and get paddled.
Yeah, my era, we missed all that. We
yeah.
get popped.
Yeah.
And that's where children's services and all
breakdown.
That came in.
That was the breakdown.
Yeah, that's where that came into where it basically took the power from the parents.
Exactly.
And the teachers, you know, more so, I would say more so back then, teachers seemed to be like they did care, because when I speak with someone of your age, more of the teachers did care. The stories are more so my age. It's like, you know, some teachers just didn't even care. They don't care.
Girl, the teacher would pull your ear. I'll never forget. Miss Ross at Henry Clay again would walk by, and she, it looked like she would take my ear from my desk to hers. That woman could pull your ear and make you holler. Yeah.
Wow. Not today. It'd be a whole fight. The police. Everything.
Yeah. That's part of the breakdown. That's part of the breakdown.
So I would say, how were you as a teenager? What type of teenager were you? Were you a good teenager, or were you?
I was bad.
You was bad?
I didn't think so. I was always nice.
Okay.
But I did.
Respectful.
Respectful. Oh, everybody was always respectful, but it was probably average. But when I look back, and after having children, you know, I was bad. I was incorrigible. I was a runaway.
Okay.
Just wanted to be in the in crowd. And my parents, you know, I came from a two-parent home.
Okay.
And they wasn't having it. But girl, I'd hit that window and be
out of there. Wow.
Out of there.
Wow.
Just to have fun. Wanted to have fun. So I guess I wasn't really bad, like, you know, dangerously bad. Just wanted to do what I wanted to do.
Just a little rebellious.
Rebellious. That's a good one. That's a good word.
Okay, yeah. So when about did you meet Tookie?
I met Tookie in, I was going to, about 70, 71. I'm getting old, girl. Look, I met him at, I went to Washington in 70. I got kicked out probably in 70. Went to Fremont. So it was 70, 71. My cousin had a class with him, a math class. I'm at Fremont.
Okay.
Girl, and she called me. She said, I want you to meet somebody. I'm like, who? She said, girl, it's this guy in my class named Tookie. She said, he was in her math class. She said, he's smart. She said, he be helping me with my work. She said, I want you to meet him. Say no less. Girl, next day, I done ditched school.
Over there,
girl. And then I seen him. I'm like, holy. He had on that waistline jacket, that big old brim hat, and I'm like, and them biscuits, and I'm like, wow.
What are biscuits? Because I know some young people are looking like biscuits.
Well, they're the Stacy Adams. We call them biscuits. They're just Stacy Adams with the little holes and the little thread around them. Girl, yeah. I met him there at Washington High School.
Mm-hmm. And from there, you guys just cool. Y'all linked up.
We was cool from that point on. I met him. It's she introduced us. And then I believe that night they had a dance.
Okay.
And it always reminds me of that movie, The Woods, because we went to this dance, mm-hmm. and that's where we actually exchanged numbers, and from there we were inseparable,
that's
you know?
So
we just went on from there, yeah. And I remember, you know, back then, his mom, bless her heart, she's still living, thank God. You know, she was strict. So I remember that, hang up the phone, get off the phone.
Curfew time, get off the phone.
So, and he got off.
How was he? Because everybody got this perception, this persona of him as just big, tough, hardcore guy that takes no mess. How was he with you?
I always tell people he was like a gentle Ben. He was really silly.
Okay.
Joke, like how the kids say you have jokes. He had jokes. Because that's what we did. We would hang out, go places, but we sitting up in the park, we laughing.
Right.
Because they clowning. Exactly. Mm-hmm. You know, of course, don't cross him. There was another side, don't get me wrong.
Okay.
But overall, he was a cream puff.
Really?
Yes.
That's what's up.
A cream puff.
And I really respect men that are tough and vicious to other men and cream puffs to that woman that they like. I think that's like the most respectful, his prettiest thing ever.
Yeah, right.
For a man to be the protector.
Right.
But she can just get away with all types of stuff.
He was so funny. I mean, the guy just kept me laughing. Don't get me wrong. He was jealous. We were young.
Okay.
16, 17 years old, and I was probably his first real girlfriend, and he was mine. So, you know, we didn't know how to act. He was jealous, but he was still just a fun person to be around.
Okay.
Like I've said before, to know him was to love him. Yeah, because he was really, I mean, and anybody he dealt with, he was that protector.
Okay.
He was that protector.
Okay.
Yeah. The friends, family, whomever, yeah.
Okay. So, because I did see the movie with Jamie Foxx. With Tookie Williams' story. Did they consult you during that, before that, or anything like that? Did you have any dealings with that? Because as I seen in the movie, they didn't mention you or nothing like that.
Nah, that was... pretty much a side that was done by Barbara.
Okay.
So if, of course, you're gonna eliminate a lot of things, and it wasn't, you know, it was for TV. It was for entertainment. And not only that, like he had told me, you know, he was limited to what he could reveal, because during that time he still had his appeals and everything. So in other words, Nakisha, that was a clean version.
Okay.
It was a clean version.
Okay.
You know? And even with the mom and the leaving him in, Miss Williams would never leave you in no hotel, and you know, you wasn't left.
Yeah, I saw that part. No. With the dad and all that.
Mm-hmm. Girl, no.
Okay. No. Okay. What made sense, because I was looking at it because I know I had the interview with you coming up, and I'm like, let me get as much information.
Right.
Because there's not that much information out there on you. Not like that. You got deep. Like, let me find Bonnie here.
I'm saving it. Because we, you know, we do plan to do something as the family. Like I say, his mom, you know, we're like this.
Okay.
And he actually has a nephew that's in the industry. He played in Snowfall. His nephew is big.
Okay.
His nephew is pretty big in the industry. So when just the time is right, we do plan to
put y'all side out.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Makes a whole lot of sense. Yeah. So tell me, when did you guys get married? And how was that day?
We got married on October 27th, 1972.
Woo.
And we were right here at...
That's years ago. Y'all, I was born in 81. I'm 40. Woo, that's like OG. Yes.
Right here on, I think it's 65th in Vermont, Bridal's Chapel. Mm. And it was just me, him, he was 18, I was 16, so my mom had to sign.
Okay.
And what I did admire is, like, he went and asked my parents for my hand.
Mm-hmm.
We didn't just elope or anything. Okay. He went and asked my dad, could he marry me?
Aww.
And,
that's that good stuff.
Because, you know, his family was from New Orleans. So
okay.
That's that Southern hospitality. Mm-hmm. So he knew how to behave.
Right.
He knew how to behave. So yeah, he asked my dad for my hand. My dad was kind of not for it. My mom was like so tired of me hopping out of windows and running away, mm-hmm. and she had to report it because back then it was called incorrigible.
Incorrigible.
So okay. If she didn't report me as a runaway and I got in and something happened, they could hold her accountable. So she was like, she ain't gonna stop going after this man and running behind this man. So, let
them get married.
Yeah, let them get married. So she did. So it was me, him, and I don't know if I think in the movie he mentioned Cherry Prince, Bimbo. Bimbo is doing life now.
Okay.
He was up in Pelican Bay, but Bimbo was our best man.
Mm.
And yeah, so we went there and got married, and they did the little rice thing and all that. Yeah.
That's what's up.
Uh huh. So yeah.
That's what's up. So
in 72.
So today will be how many years?
So we were married from 1972. We divorced while he was locked up.
Okay.
He divorced me in 1985.
Okay.
No, 84. Because I had my daughter. He divorced me on Christmas, little jive turkey. It was Christmas Day, 1984. And because he was doing his pro per thing, so he was just practicing his law. So he did it on his own. And I got the paperwork, and it was finalized in 84, December 25th. Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay.
So we were actually legally married for 13 years.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. We were legally married for 13 years. Yeah.
Okay. I got Tookie Williams.
It was 85. I take that back. It was 85.
Y'all know it's like legendary lady. Like, I'm real here. Life.
Yeah, I'm here. I'm glad to be here.